And Trouba, 19-year-old defenseman, highly regarded by the Jets Hockey Club, and with good reason. Outlet pass. Here comes Atkinson. Top of the circle. Let's one fly. And Montoya turns it aside. Although from nearby Brandon, obviously growing up a Winnipeg Jets fan, happy to see the Jets back in Winnipeg, and a little extra emotion from Calvert tonight as a result. 90-plus seconds into this hockey game. Federtutin, Johansson, right side, Nick Foligno. Foligno drops the pass for Johansson. Sharp angle shot, Montoya. The stick save. Wheeler now stepped into there by Foligno on the left wing. Puck carried out here by Grant Clixon from center ice. He'll just rifle in. Far side, Savard. There with Ryan Murray. Approaching the eight-minute mark. Puck flipped to the back. A shot from the point. Held by McKenna. Scoreless first period. Jack Johnson battling against Jokinen. Jokinen, Setoguchi in front there. Thorburn. Jackets defend. And it's Jenner coming back and helping his defenseman. Boone Jenner had it knocked away. Denied the stop made by McKenna of this Jets hockey club, and he had some pointed words to members of the Winnipeg media for the club's disappointing effort, in particular Saturday night. Less than a minute to go. Winnipeg lost 6-4 to Dallas at home. A scramble in front, down is Montoya. Goal, and it's waved off. The goal is waved off by referee Tim Peel. This is one of the criteria. And the officials now talking here.
Boy, I'll tell you what, he did not interfere with the goaltender whatsoever. You can see Montoya down, and then you can see Enstrom, and then the push from Trouba from behind. And here you'll get a look at an overview of it. As again, Montoya makes a save, and that puck goes into the net before Calvert even hits the crossbar.
And we'll get the definitive word here after the review. It's now being looked at in the situation room in Toronto. And again, from our vantage point, it looked like a good goal.
The call on the ice was no goal. You said it, Rims, it was Tim Peel was adamant about the fact that it was no goal.
Here we go.
This is a non-reviewable play. The call on the ice stands. The goalie was unable to play his position.
We will certainly be provided some type of explanation as well from the folks in Toronto, and we'll pass it along. But from our vantage point, I don't think Montoya had any problem playing that puck. This time he's able to turn it aside with the right pass. Upended, Shifley, jackets, Foligno had it briefly, stopped in front. Trouba's stick broke as Foligno stepped into him, looked at the official for a call. Meantime, Bufflin cruising through, and the shot off the blocker there of McKenna. Shovel to the corner, and there is Cam Atkinson. Atkinson sends it around the boards. Matt Calvert. Left wing, out to center. Calvert looks to the right side. Savard has joined the rush. David Savard from a sharp angle off the toe of Montoya.
Think it'd be a minor penalty, but in the act of shooting, that is not the case.
Well, Todd Richard lobbied for it. He didn't get it. And now 4-on-4. Dubinsky off the wing. Dubinsky with a backhand shot that Montoya was able to get a pad on. 13-8 the shots. Now Calvert with an attempted shot. Bouncing puck in front. Calvert continues to pursue it. And there's Ladd on to Bufflin. Joining the rush, Little. Little for the right wing board. Stick save. Rebound sent wide by Ladd. Ryan Murray. 2 seconds left of the Shifley penalty. He is standing at the penalty bench and out. Brief power play. 15 seconds. Out of the box, this is Shifley moving in. The shot blocked and held.
Sticking to the program. Short shifts, you know, in the second period, that's not always easy for a D-man, especially if we're not getting pucks deep. So our forwards have to do a good job getting pucks deep so our D can get off and have short shifts, and that's going to be the key.
Como, a shot there by Anisimov, steered off to the corner. Tootin remains out after taking that high stick. Currently, Nikitin paired with Johansson. Jackets walk to the net. There's Montoya able to squeeze that on the right side, and we get some pushing and shoving. Jenner. Those two had a battle in the first period, serving 5-minute majors. Knocked down was Atkinson. Gets back up. Crowd again looking for a penalty call. None forthcoming. Here now, Dubinsky fires towards the net. That shot blocked. Ricochets in front. In the goal crease area. Montoya down. And will cover up in the blue paint. Was a similar type play with the Jackets going to those dirty areas in front of the net. And Calvert called for goalie interference. I don't know if I necessarily agree with that. But and here it's off the glove of McKenna. And tumbling over him was Scheifele. It's moved. Trouba with a shot. Ricochets off a leg and wide. Frolik in pursuit. Jackets chip it up, but not out. Atkinson attempts to do so. Meantime, Evander Kane in front for Scheifele, and he scores. 1-0. Kane with a perfect feed to Scheifele, who shovels it home. Scheifele, who came into tonight's contest with 7 points in the last two games and a two-point scoring streak, has added two. That scoring streak with a goal here.
Now that's where the Jackets again have a tough time getting the puck outside the zone. They come back in. Kane, he just forces the front of the net. And Scheifele, he stays with it. Again, is able to get that puck high over top of Mike McKenna. But what a play there by Kane.
If you're just joining us now, the Jackets minus two players for the balance of the hockey game. And that happened early on. Sure, first shift for Dalton Prout, who went awkwardly into the boards. Prout out with a upper body injury. Winnipeg captain slips and falls. Jack Johnson draped all over him. Up high, Little once more. Stick handles, deals. Moved by Enstrom, middle of the corner. Jokinen, Little. Umberger slips and falls. Jokinen, Bufflin, wrist shot. There's McKenna. Square to the shooter. 2:25 left in the Atkinson's double minor. Puck rifled in. Jokinen trying to cut it off on the left wing boards. Black to the point. Bufflin will let one fly and scores. Power play goal as it ricochets. And that is the first power play goal for these Winnipeg Jets since October. Their last power play goal was late in October. They were 3-for-48 on the road coming in tonight.
Now watch the shot from that point. Again, Bufflin loads it up and you'll see the deflection right in the slot area right there. I got a feeling, and it may be Little that got a stick on it. There's the view. And that was it. Exactly was it. Little gets that stick on it. That shot right on the ice.
10 seconds remain. And Atkinson double minor. Jokinen slides it back. Bufflin able to save it there at the line. Two. And gloved with 1 second left in the Atkinson penalty. Frolik, Scheifele, Patrick Kane, again, Evander Kane is with him. Savard, Johansson off the bench, looking to continue a point scoring streak. Can't think of a better time here for that to continue. Jacket trailing by two, and Matt Calvert sweeps it off into the corner. Tied up, wraparound attempt by Umberger, scores! How about that? R.J. Umberger with a wraparound. Johansson and Calvert join him in the zone, and the Jackets finally beat Montoya, and Umberger showing that energy.
Here's where you get a look for the Jackets at that blue line. You watch the play right here by Calvert. Again, protects the puck, protects the puck. What's he do? Makes sure he gets it below the goal line. And when he does so, hey, Johansson takes his man. He tries to find space, but it's Umberger who goes back the other way. He reverses the flow, and he catches Montoya really back on his heels. Nice play right there.
Calvert now left wing with Dubinsky and Atkinson. Nice move by Calvert. On to Atkinson, the pass behind him. Savard sends it towards the net. And now Evander Kane sends it away. 3-on-1. Trying to come back as Matt Calvert. Kane fires and scores. Jackets caught up ice. An odd man rush, 3-on-1. Kane kept it and beats McKenna far side.
Now you talk about luck. Again, this is an example right here where the Jackets, they come across the line with speed. You get Savard, who tries to direct that shot towards the net. What do the Winnipeg Jets do? They do a great job of blocking the shot and then back the other way with speed. Again, Kane, he has a little bit of help. He decides to do it on his own to beat Mike McKenna on that stick side. In fact, it's a glove side.
Johnson rifles in. Nikitin and Tootin come over the boards. Foligno on the high slot on that turnover. Fires a shot. He missed the mark. Off the backboard. Here's another attempt. A goal. Off the point.
is what the Jackets wanted to do. That puck is dumped in, and what do? You've got to go in with a little bit of speed, and you take the defenseman. And when Trout does so, watch the end result. Good job getting it deep, forcing the goaltender to play it. He lays it out to the defense, and then here comes Trout. He takes the body. Buffman, he turns the puck over. The end result, the Jackets shoot. They pick up that rebound off the end board, and Tootin finds a way to put it into the back of the net.
A scoreless first, and now a wide-open hockey game. Jenner hands to Letestu. Frolik unable to play it. Across the line, it's backhanded towards the net. A scramble there, and Montoya kicks the left pad out and makes the save. Kane, who missed the previous six games, certainly adds a dimension to the Winnipeg offense. And we've seen that with his speed. Despite a couple of times going awkwardly into the boards, and one time blocking a shot. Meantime, late in the shift, Foligno into the offensive zone, fires a shot, and Montoya's got it and gloves it and hangs on.